Connor, I truly don't know how to even begin to explain to you what you mean to me. I cannot believe this day is here, over a decade in the making. It feels full circle that I'm writing this to you in my childhood bedroom. The same room I used to stay up late in, texting you and telling all my friends about you. I promised to love you for the rest of my life and beyond. I did not know I could love or be loved in this way. I know you are my home. You challenge me, listen to me, and are there for me in every way I need. I hope I love you in all the ways you need. And I hope you will tell me if I'm not. To be loved is to be known. I have never been known or known someone else the way that we know each other. I know in my heart we will have an amazing life together. Together we can handle anything. I'm so ready for the adventure of a lifetime with you. I love you most and more than words. Yours, Carson.
Hey, Carson and Connor, my two favorite people on the planet. I'm super excited for you today.
I love you both very much.
Oh, Carson!
And just want you to always remember to be each other's best friend. And I know that y'all are gonna do great and do great things and have an amazing life together. And just know that I love you always.
Oh, my baby boy. My sweet child of mine. Today's your day. And you know how much I'd give anything if your daddy could have been here. But I want you to know that he and I are so very proud of you. So excited that you found Carson and that she is your run true love. And the other thing is I know without a doubt that God is going to give you that fairy tale love story that he gave your dad and I love you, my baby girl. This is going to go on your boutonniere today, wearing your dad.
Close to your heart.
Oh, darling, the day has finally arrived. The day we have been waiting for over 14 months for. This day to me feels so large yet so small compared to the thousands of days ahead of us. I've loved you every day, ever since we went to the first Rangers game. Even through all the nerves, I knew you were the one. I can't wait to make it official. I'll see you soon. I love you more. Love, Connor James Thompson.
You look beautiful.
Thank you.
I love you.
Thank you.
Carson and Connor. It's been such a wonderful blessing to me to get to know you over the last year and a half. I believe that I speak for everyone when I say that we are full of confidence in the future life that you hold together. For today, your two lives that have shared a long intertwining story now officially become one story together. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love's not jealous. It's not boastful or proud. It's not rude. It does not demand its own way. It's not irritable, and it keeps no record of being wrong. It does not rejoice in injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up, never loses faith, Love is always hopeful and endures through every circumstance. Love will last forever. And it's this type of love on which beautiful marriages are built on. I, Connor.
I, Connor.
Take you, Carson.
Take you, Carson.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
I, Carson.
Take you, Connor.
Take you, Connor.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. You may kiss.
If you don't know me, I am Russell Hardy. I went to college with Connor.
Truthfully, he kept me sane, I think just as much as I did you. Helped me with music theory, how to stop blaming my professors for my bad grades. 90% of our friendship is like arguments about marching band, listening to music nobody's heard of ever, and the usually, typically awful experience of being a Texas Rangers fan until this year, baby! Thank you. Go Rangers.
Connor taught me a very important lesson that I still take with me today, and that is to never take life too seriously. Always find the laughing moments. Always take every little cherished moment that you can, because you never know. Sometimes that's it. And I really appreciate that. So congratulations to you and Carson. Carson, girl, peace be with you, because I've lived with him for 3 years. Girl, but yes, a toast to you guys.
All right, here comes. The most important thing that Connor ever gave me was a second family. Man, they took over, your dad, your mom, and it's just like, I have these new parents. I'm an only child. I don't have brothers, except for him. And now I get a sister. Cheers!
All right, hi. Most of y'all don't know me, but I'm Jasmine. Carson and I have been friends since meeting at UNT during First Flight Week.
My name is Katie. If you don't know me, I am from Cameron, Texas.
One night, we were hanging out at her apartment, and as friends do, we told each other our social security numbers. We have the exact same 5 first numbers. I like to think this means that the universe knew we were going to be together one day.
Carson, you've been such a treasure to me and all in this room. You're passionate, you're creative, you love deeply, you have more empathy in one pee than most do in their whole body. I'm honored to get to call you my friend and to get to stand here on one of the biggest days of your life and celebrate your marriage to a good man. Connor, you're not a vampire, which is a little disappointing to 14-year-old Carson, but you're better because you're her real life love story. There will never, ever be a way that I can thank you for what you've done for Carson.
I wasn't lucky enough to know Carson and Connor as middle school sweethearts, but I was able to be there when Connor came back into her life. A frequent topic that would come up was, when was Connor going to propose? Connor, if you didn't already know this, I'm sorry, but we were talking about that ring for months. Like, Connor's mom told Carson's mom that Connor had this ring from his grandma. We dreamt up that whole wedding in the parking lot. May your souls always feel safe together. May you always see the good in each other. And may you have a filling and strong marriage to Carson and Connor.
So if you could all raise a glass to celebrate Carson and Connor finally getting here to this night after all these years.
I wanna the hand inside you. I wanna take the breath that's true. I look to you and I see nothing. I look to you to see the truth. Live your life, you go where shadow. You'll come apart and you'll go blind. Some kind of night.